I've heard from some of you that you are struggling with the whole concept of division and hangman division when you are changing an improper fraction into a mixed number. So if the whole concept of division is still a little bit foggy or just intimidating and freaks you out, try this instead. So say we had the fraction, 14 fifths. Basically, what you are going to be thinking about is how to group these numbers. So we have 14 in our numerator, which means that we have 14 of something, 14 things that are fifths size, or 14, you can think of, divided into five groups. Either way, you'll get the same answer. So, another strategy that some students have found to be really, really helpful is to think of it like this. So, think of the 14, your numerator, as the 14 things that you have. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Okay, so you've got 14 of those things. Think of the fifths now as how many groups you've got. So groups of five. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4. Not quite enough to make another group of five. So I can see that I have one group, two groups. That's two whole groups, two entire groups. So if it's two whole groups, that is your whole number, two. And now for your fractional part, you need to look at how many you have left over. How many did you have left that didn't fit nicely into a group of five, that denominator number? Well, we can count them. We've got 1, 2, 3, 4. Got four of them. So that would be four left over. And then our denominator just stays the same because we're still talking about the same types of pieces. So if you're thinking about this as a division problem, 14 divided by 5, this kind of a picture might be very helpful for you. Or you can think of it in terms of hangman division. If you have 14 fifths, same problem, and you don't want to draw it out, but you want to think of it as like pulling groups out, well, just like what we drew, basically what we need to think of is how many groups of five could I pull out of 14, or could I circle in that 14? Well, one group would get me to five. Well, I could probably take out another group at least. Two groups would get me to 10. So that's awesome. Three groups, that would get me to 15. And unfortunately, I only have 14. Not quite enough to make a third group. So I can take out two groups of five. Two groups of five would mean that I take out a total of 10. I got that 10 by saying, well, two groups of five. And since I'm taking it out and trying to find out what I have left, subtraction is going to be the taking away or the taking out method that we use. So when we do 14 minus 10, we get 4. Notice you've got a 2, a 4, and the 5. That should be very familiar because that was, in fact, our mixed number that we got when we drew it out. The 2 comes from the number of whole groups that you were able to pull out. That's your whole number, just like you circled two groups of five. The 4 becomes your numerator. That's how many you still have left. They still count, even though they didn't make a whole nother group. They still count for something. And then our five, it's fifths. Everything is still the same size piece. We still have fifths. So that's where we get our 2 and 4/5 when we do hangman division. Now, if you're still not quite sure and you'd like to try a couple and then see my explanation, here you go. I'm going to put up a problem and I want you to draw it out and try circling the groups that you're taking out to show that model of division. Then look at your leftovers and decide what your fractional part is. So you'll have a whole number and a fractional part for the mixed number. Once you see the problem, hit pause so that you can work it out for yourself and get your answer, and then hit play again and you can check to see if you were right. Okay, hit pause. Okay, so that's what it'll look like if you have 17 of something and you're dividing it into groups of 3. So we've got our groups of 3 circled to see how many whole groups of 3 can fit into, or we could take out of, 17. So that would be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 whole groups. And then we've got 2 leftovers. So that becomes our numerator. We still have some more. And our denominator stays the same. We're still talking about groups of 3. So basically what we're saying is we have 2/3 of a group of 3 left. We don't have 3/3 enough to make one whole, but we've got 2/3 left. Give yourself a woohoo if you got that right. All right. Now, show it in a division problem. Remember that 17/3 basically means 17 divided by 3, or 17 divided by 13. Sorry, divided by 3. Okay, now, how many groups of 3 could we pull out of 17? Well, the great thing about hangman division is you can try pulling out one group at a time and taking out a group of 3, taking out a group of 3, taking out a group of 3 until you can't take out any more groups of 3. Then figure out how many whole groups you took out. Or you can think, 3 times what gets me really close to 17? How many whole groups of 3 could I take out in one big chunk? And then deal with the leftovers. So, why don't you try this one in whatever way works best for you. Hit pause now. Well, if you're like me and you like multiplication facts and you think to yourself, well, what times 3 can get me close to 17? That way I could pull out a big chunk of 3 all at once. Well, that would be 5. 5 groups of 3 would be 15 that you could take out all at once. And then you'd have 2 left over. So our answer would be 5 and 2/3. Now the great thing about hangman division is, what if you guessed wrong here? What if you didn't take out enough in one chunk? Not a problem. It's pretty awesome. With hangman division, you can keep on subtracting out groups of 3 until you have no more to take away. So I'll show that for you too. And eventually, you'll learn to be more efficient and take out the biggest chunk that you can. So if we have 17 divided by 3, if I didn't think to take out a group of 5, but I know I've got enough to take out a group of 1, I could take out a group of 1. There would be 3 in that one group, and I'd have 14 left. Okay, let's take out another one group of 3. One group of 3 would have 3 in it. Take that out and get 11. All right, I can keep going. Another one group of 3. Take it out. I've got 8. Another one group of 3. Take it out. and I've got five. I'm getting toward the end here. Can I take out one more group? Yes, I definitely can. That's going to be a group of three. And just two left over, and I'm running out of room here. So two left over. Woo! Okay, now if you see this, we have one, two, three, four, five groups of three that we took out. See a five anywhere else? Yeah, right here. This works. It's not very efficient, but it works if you're stuck. You can just keep taking groups of three out. Eventually, once you know your multiplication facts really well, you can take out a chunk of five and get down to the remainder step in just one step. But this works too. You still have your five, although it's not as neat and clean. And in a division problem, the answer really will go up there. And then you've also got your two-thirds as well. You've got it right here in the remainder. Two-thirds. So if you get stuck on division, if you're using on division and you're using this hangman division, you're going to be just fine. It might take you a few more steps, a group, but you will get to the right answer. So don't give up on yourself and don't be scared of this division thing. You can draw it out as a picture. You can continue taking out one group at a time if you need to, or you can really push yourself to be efficient and think of your math facts, like five groups of three would be 15, and take those out all at once. So you definitely have options. I'm going to want to eventually see this by like December, January when we do long division, but for now, this can absolutely work, or drawing it can absolutely work too. I hope that helped to explain how you can use division to make an improper fraction into a mixed number.